Welcome back to the Weekend Express. We are so glad that you're still watching us. We are so glad that you're still with us because we are now joined by a very interesting lady. I do not even know how to introduce her, so I want her to introduce herself because she has so many things. Kamentu, did I get that right?
Yes, Kamentu.
So what should I call you?
Whatever you want. What do you want to call me?
In this context, because we want to talk about the film content policy,
okay.
You know.
All right, okay. So I'm a writer and I'm a journalist as well. But I'm also interested in just matters of the public public interest. So one of the things that I've been doing is I've been a member of the Film Bill Committee,
yes,
which has been just really trying to intervene on the issue of the Cap 222, which is what a lot of artists and creative professionals had a problem with last year, October, when there was a lot of noise because of the KFCB draft.
Yes.
So what we've been doing is we've been just now coming up with a better bill so that the creative professionals are taken care of, so that, you know, like it's something that's actually going to be very helpful to the industry and that's going to be acceptable on both sides, from on the government side as well as us as creative professionals.
But it has felt almost, Kiwa, that the creative industry is just whining too much because everybody knows that Ezekiel Mutua, just in case you're joining us, this is just the draft bill that the KFCB, the Kenya Classification Board, because they're supposed to classify, but they also want to curtail certain things that you people feel are not good. For example, for me, I don't see that it's very bad for them to be rating film content.
Yeah.
Or they're not taking away your freedom of expression if they want you to be able, for example, to get a license to shoot weddings, because those are some of the contentious ones. For you, as a creative, what is the main one that is contentious for you?
Well, okay. I'm interested in how you say that, how we artists look like we're whining. And I think the background to that is that if you look at Kenya's history, for a long time, the arts has been suppressed. In the time of the Kenyatta regimes, the Moi regimes, the creative industry was looked like as the enemy. So like some of the provisions in Cap 22 say something like that you have to have a policeman on set if you're going to have a play, that you have to have your script, film script or theater script, that it needs to be approved by authorities. And so those are some of the things that we see, that it's sort of coming from a different context. Like right now, this country is so different. We're not having those same wars that used to be there in the 80s and the 90s and even beyond that. But we as artists, we want to be able to, we want the freedom to just practice, carry out our work. We want the freedom to carry out our work. And so that's the reason that we've been engaging with it, to try to get out.
I know that you know, artists are very passionate. I like that I'm an artist too.
Yes.
But when they're talking about protecting children, why you know, are there parts of this draft bill that are good for you and that can continue and that you're carrying on in this? Because I saw the other day you guys were involved in a new sort of set that was working. 4 days ago, you, Gashara, and several other people. So what came out of it?
Yeah. Okay, so we had a meeting actually even yesterday. And so that was drawing up a policy framework. So, but first, let me answer what you asked about the issue of children. So first thing is that so many of us are parents. Like, it's not like artists do not have children and do not care.
It may look like that. By the way, you carry placards and make a lot of noise. It may just look like that.
I know. I understand where that is. And I also understand the head of KFCB, Ezekiel Mutua. I think that his heart is in the right place in the sense of trying to protect children. However, starting from the position that we are spoiling things, we are spoiling the country, I think that's a very dangerous thing, because if you look at the number of productions that come out, I've never, as a journalist, I don't remember ever reviewing any film or any book and saying, oh my God, this is going to spoil children's lives, you know. So I think Ezekiel Mutua has a lot of energy, and I think it's a very good thing that he has that energy. The thing is that we just need to channel it to make sure that it's, rather than seeming to oppose the artist's well-being and interest, that it's actually, it's building, that it's, that his energy is used towards making Kenya like the way Nollywood is, you know, that kind of thriving industry, you know, the way Bollywood is. So that's the thing.
So we
do believe, which is the reason why we have come out. We're not just making noise, but we're saying that, okay, let's go clause by clause and see what we can do. So we're being proactive as well. We're being proactive and trying to put in our input. In fact, tomorrow till Tuesday, there's another discussion about it. Now it's the committee that's been tasked on behalf of the industry to just get it straightened. And so we're meeting with the KFCB so that we can be able to see, okay, this is what you've put, because they've also been improving it. They haven't just been sitting down. Yes. So we can see that this is what they have and this is what we have. So how can we meet in the middle?
So far, it is looking good. So on behalf of all your creative people, we can tell them that, yes, there could have been contentious issues, but they are being resolved.
Yes.
And most of them, yes. You know, if they come, so where is your meeting next Tuesday and who can participate?
So it's happening on Sunday, tomorrow, Tuesday.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's going to be in Naivasha. It's going to take a bit of time. So okay. That's why it's like okay. About 2.5 days.
Okay.
But in the meantime, there's also a way that other people, even Kenyans, because we're not saying that we as artists we are segregating ourselves from the society, because Kenyans are our audiences, mm-hmm. and without our audiences we are nothing, because they're the ones who are buying our productions, watching our productions. It's so they can also contribute. So What I'd ask people to do is that there's actually all these documents are online.
Okay.
So the film policy, the latest one is 2015.
Yes.
So the film policy and then the draft, the CAP 222
yes.
is also online. So people can just look through them. And if they have any feedback, they can write to creativesinkenya@gmail.com. Mm-hmm. That's creatives.
In Kenya.
Yeah. So creatives
Gmail.
With an S.
Yeah.
creativesinkenya@gmail.com.
Yes. So if you want to continue this discussion when she is wearing her creatives art, then creativesinkenya@gmail.com. But I cannot have her in studio and not ask about her many controversial things. Madam President, is
tell
it
me
true
that
you are running this year?
You know, I've been quiet. I don't want to talk so much about that because I don't want to get up expectations and then at the end of the day it's like we're not able to like get to the finishing line, because that's what happened the last time. So I think for now, like, we are working towards that. Like it would be a great thing, because I feel a sense of responsibility as a Kenyan to make this country a much better place, like all this potential.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, going back to the word of whining, I don't like whining. Like, whining just puts me off.
Absolutely.
So
beautiful.
I want to answer your question.
Yes.
I want to
yes.
answer your
are
question.
Are you running? You have got
so,
to be precise today.
I will not answer that, but what will be answered is if my name will be on the ballot box, if we have been active. I can't tell for now.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that it is all of us who will have to see that.
So
we
are not too sure whether you are going to be in the ballot.
Let's wait and see. Let's keep looking.
We keep looking.
Yeah.
Now, can we address the little matter of some photos that you had put that were very controversial?
Okay.
Yes.
Which photos?
There were interesting photos that you had put.
Tell me about them.
I'll tell you about it, but that's because
I have a lot of photos.
You talked about election, and I want you to address this. You know why?
Uh-huh.
Because every young person, when we bring them here, we want to know whether you have a voter's card and whether you are going to do your due diligence.
Uh-huh.
Because we have like a few days to go.
Yes.
And we are being told that other people are not even going to vote. Now, as somebody who will influence people, have you registered? And are you telling people about this?
Yes, of course. I
you
registered.
Have your voter's card?
I got my voter's card, in 2002.
Have you confirmed it?
Yes, I have.
You have,
I have
confirmed
yeah.
it. And so now we know either we will see you on the ballot, mm-hmm. but you're also going to participate.
Yeah. Yeah, but I also want to say something about the apathy, because it's something
yes,
that like
yes,
I've had,
way, yes.
even my own friends, like I know people, or even like if you see on your social media timelines, mm-hmm. like you see so many people saying, I'm not going to vote.
Mm-hmm.
So I think we need to understand why that is happening. And there's a lot of apathy, because I think there's a lot of disappointment in the political class.
For you, which one is the biggest disappointment? Very quickly, because today, by the mm-hmm. way, I saw you take a selfie with our fitness people right
oh, yes.
over there.
Yes.
And they're just Jimmy and they're with Tamima. I don't know how she's going to do this in high heels.
She'll be sweating.
I don't know how she's going to do this in high heels, but we told you we are going to offer solutions. So very quickly, what you wanted to say.
I think in this, the challenge is not so much to the voters. The challenge is to the people in the political class, and I include myself there, that are we offering enough value such that Kenyans feel that, and yeah, it's worth my time to get out there, stand in the sun or whatever, to be able to vote? Because right now, the way the politics is that it's been a very negative politics, and so that's, we need to change that, and that's one of the things, one of the reasons that I'm interested in, that I am in this space. Yeah, just making it something that, a politics that adds value
yes.
rather than takes away, because all this time, it's a politics that kills, it's a politics of violence, it's a politics that steals.
Mm.
So we need to start working, creating.
We need to be accountable and be ensure that we talk to people well so that they can, you know, they
we
can
need
get
to be
this.
Creating a politics of value.
Politics of value
so
is, the last word that we are going to have right
yes.
now before we go into our fitness. We will continue this discussion with Kingwa Kimenshu. Remember that you can be able to continue tweeting us at Ms. Tamima, at Adhiambo, and at KTN News. Now, this is the fun part. This is the place where we tell you what it is that you can do to remain fit. I have really I loved to have been there with you, Tamima, but I forgot the shoes. That's why I'm wondering how you're going to do this thing with those type of shoes. I also forgot my gym gear.
Did you see Mariah Carey on heels?
So do you think you want to join them? Does Kinyua want to join them?
Let's
I think Kinyua wants to join them.